Okay. Hi guys, today we are going to look at there are few concepts. One is linear optimization, from in which we are moving to non-linear optimization. Actually, you are stipulated syllabuses of non-linear optimization in order to understand the basics or foundation of linear optimization is essential, so that I'll touch upon, then I'll end up with the non-linear optimization. So this is part of your third unit. So what are all the types you have? For this optimization technique is mainly meant for prescriptive decisions. For the prescriptive decisions, these are all the techniques useful: linear optimization, integer optimization, decision analysis, non-linear and non-smooth optimization. Non-linear is different. Non-linear, otherwise called smooth and non-smooth. What and all these all, let us see. Optimization models with uncertainty, with certainty. So there are several, and continuous and discrete. So these are all the types available. So let us start with, whenever you are working with the Excel, above the higher version of Excel, you can use Excel solver. So your textbook also based on Excel solver only. The author has illustrated lot of case studies, examples. Today morning I tried with my Excel, it doesn't support. This is add-on. You need to bring this add-on for the higher end of Excel version, or else you need to use different software. With Excel, there are three methods you can solve. One is simplex LP. This simplex LP is meant for linear and linear integer optimization problem. So this is the trick or technique for linear optimization. You can do with the solver. This is one kind of button. See, you are right now seeing Excel na, sorry, Microsoft Word na. See, if I click macro, then if I click new window, it is like that. There is a component called solver in Excel. So using that Excel, you can solve these three techniques. One is simplex LP, that is for linear optimization. There are two more techniques available for the non-linear optimization. Among those two, GRG non-linear optimization, evolutionary optimization. When to use what, again, there is a distinction between these two. Solving non-linear optimization problem, this is used for solving complex nonlinear and nonlinear integer problem. I can say, or I can put it in this way: GRG nonlinear is meant for solving simplest problem. Evolutionary, this is meant for nonlinear only, but it is for much more complex problem. So if we use solver, automatically you will get some report. What if analysis is one more technique available with Excel also. So that is, that also you can use for this kind of optimization problem, what if analysis. This is available into my Excel. So you can try either with what if analysis option, or you can try with Excel solver option. These are all the two techniques you can work for optimization problem using Excel software, or else you need to rely on Python code, R code, or any of the MATLAB code, any of other kind of code. That's it. There are some tools also available, which I'm not sure. So this is what I wanted to introduce today for the today's session. In the last session, we have discussed optimization technique is limited to, not limited to only computer science. It is extensive towards any discipline. Transportation, the major domain is transportation. All the kind of transportation problems, all the type of ship, cargo, flight, all such kind of transportation, even the optimized solution, optimized path. Even if you are laying a railway track, so railway track, how you can plan. So that also one of the optimization problem. Bus routes, connecting cities, even when you are, imagine you are going to become an omnibus proprietor or service provider. So when you are buying a bus, you need to work on that. Which route, which source to which destination gives the best profit, where the crowd is more, what kind of budget the bus which you are purchasing, and what is the cost you are fixing. So it is between two A-class cities, then the cost which you are fixing, it can be anything, Bangalore to Hyderabad, the very first time I visited Hyderabad for Vedic, I have invested 3,200 rupees ticket for the bus services. So that much costly bus also available. The same Bangalore to Hyderabad, I have traveled with 1,000 rupees also. So they need to think and target. So which kind of audiences we can attract? What is the nature of bus? This is also one kind of optimization problem. Everywhere optimization problem is available. The moment you are planning for a tour, you will be working on optimization problem. There are several solutions, several methods of going for tour. You can go by travels, or you can book a car, or you can go by railway services, or you can go by flight, any method, or you can get a known person car and you can drive and you can travel. There are a lot of method. Then you need to sit and optimize. What are all the constraints? So given the number of days for your tour would be lesser. Then expenditure, budget. So these two are your constraints. Upon several constraints, how best solution we are taking, that is called optimal solution. What are all the possible or favorite solutions for our problem or our situation or context is feasible solution. So from the feasible solution, we need to take the best solution. It has alternative solution. Whenever you have many solutions, out of that you need to find out the feasible solution. From the feasible solution, you need to find out the optimal solution. So whenever these kind of, that optimal solution is what? Maximize or minimize. What is maximize? If it is tour, it is a minimization problem. Within lesser number of days, you need to visit more places. So that is maximization problem. More places. Within lesser, more, with more places, you need to travel with the cheapest price. So that is minimization problem. So given the context, you can fix whether it is minimization or maximization. This is the objective function. Your goal of the optimization is to find out the minimum best solution or maximum the best solution depending upon the context. That's all. So these are all the situations you can apply this kind of optimization problem. What are all the ingredients of optimization? Last class we have discussed. Decision variables you need to identify. Model, decision models you need to identify. There are several models, several techniques available for solving this kind of problem. So which model we are choosing? Constraints. Every problem has its own constraints. Then objectives or goals or performance measure. So these are all the component we need to identify before stepping into or solving or deriving the conclusion. Now look at, let us consider minimization function effects. This is what your objective function, not a defined. This is a generic way it is written. So for that function, you need to find out if at all non-linear constraints are there, or linear constraints are there, or simple boundaries are there. First, we need simple terms. I can say boundaries. What is this all? Nothing to worry. Shortly, I will be discussing with a detailed example. So with a very understandable manner, I have picked one of the internet material through in which I'll be working, then structural constraint. So this is what the component or the parameter we may need to identify. 1 minute. So next, if you come to the next topic of discussion, you are the primary responsibility of working with optimization is to either minimize or maximize. So if at all maximize function, you can represent the max of f of x. If it is minimum, minimize function, minus min of minus f of x. This is the functional notation. So you need to identify the min and max. Whenever it is a curvature nature, these all fall into non-linear optimization. Whenever straight lines are involved, that is termed as linear optimization. This is non-linear. Let us go to one of the hands-on or one of the kind of illustration with the numerical example. Then we come back for the theory. I'm going to change the slide. That means, hope so you can able to see the screen. Solving linear programming problem. So first you need to identify the decision variable. You need to write the objective function. You need to identify the constraints, then you need to identify the method which method you want to solve, which way you want to solve. You can solve through simplex method. Operation research, this is one of the famous problems, simplex method. You can solve through R, R coding method, R graphical method, R using Excel open solver method. Then finally, you can construct a graph. The boundary conditions you can apply, then you can come out with a graph. Then you can identify the feasible region. From the feasible only, you can find out the optimum region or optimal solution or optimum point. First, we need to come out with a feasible. Then only we can take decision on optimal. These are all the seven major steps involved with any kind of optimization problem. Be it linear or non-linear, it has seven steps. So let us go through the example. Hope so you can see the screen and it is in the form of readable form. You need to read this problem. A bakery manufacturers two kinds of cookies they are manufacturing. Chocolate chip and caramel variety. The bakery forecast the demand for at least 80 caramel and 120 chocolate chips cookies daily. So how much demand per day would come for the bakery is 80 caramel flavor, 120 chocolate chip flavor. Due to the limited ingredients and employees, so every concern has, every firm has their own limitation. Budget issue, the space issue, machinery issues, ingredient issue, what could be anything. See, the person is running a bakery or manufacturing unit doesn't mean that he is the capable of 1,000 units. He may be capable of only 3 units, 2 units or single unit. So that is what he is constrained. So upon that constraint, how you can find out the best optimal solution in order to meet the demand. So that is the problem fit into the category optimization problem. If you look at here, what is the problem statement is, this is what your expected demand. So now, another constraint. Can manufacture at the most 120 only. Caramel cookies, that particular bakery cannot manufacture more than 120 piece. Similarly, 140 chocolate chip only can be manufactured through that piece. See, look at here. This is what demand forecasting. This is what your capacity. Whether this meets or not, look at caramel 80, 120. Yes, I can manufacture. Expected demand is 120 chocolate chip. I am having the capacity 140 chocolate chip per day. Then what is the constraint is, to be profitable, the bakery must sell at least 240 cookies daily. Altogether, my objective is I need to sell 240 cookies. Hope so you can understand the problem statement. What kind of problem can be solved using optimization technique? You would have got some fair idea. See, even though it is a small manufacturing unit, after all 120 caramel cookies, fine. But we need to find out the optimal solution. Each chocolate chip cookie sold result in the profit. Every small piece of cookie, chocolate flavor, the profit is of 0.75. Caramel cookie, the profit is of 0.88. Now, what is my another target? We look at, there is a target. At least 240 cookies daily. How many chocolate chip and caramel cookies should be made daily to maximize the profit? Compute the maximum revenue that can be generated in a day. This is what given problem statement. We need to solve. We solve supporting component, the known phenomena. From the known phenomena, we need to approach the unknown phenomenon or finding the solution. So how we are going to approach? Look at here. Very first step is to identify the decision variable. There are two types of cookies available into the bakery. Caramel cookies, X, chocolate chip, Y. So two decision variables we have decided. X and Y are the two different decision variables. Each one is to represent each type of cookie. That's all. There are two types of cookies available. Each of the variable is associated with one type of cookie. Now we need to write the objective function. What is objective function? we need to improve the profit. How you can improve the profit? You need to form the equation. If you look at here, it is explicitly clear that it is a linear relationship. Directly, it is linear relationship. So, $0.88 is a profit, a cent is a profit for one of the cookie. 0.75 is the profit for yet another cookie. So, we need to combine these two. So, this objective function, expertise only can write. Nobody will give. I say in the optimal optimization problem, than even that seven steps, which is very tough, is writing the objective function is very toughest part. So that is where our intellectual effort is required. Look at here, x and y are non-negative. It should be non-negative. Never we can say for minus 5 cookies I have manufactured. You can't say no. I can say only one cookie I have prepared today. I have prepared 50 cookies. I have prepared 500 cookies. That way only you can say. Or else you can say worst case, since I am not feeling well or holiday, band, Bharat band, so I couldn't prepare even single cookies, zero cookies. Never you can say negative cookies, no? So it is a constraint. So that we need to write down the constraint of the variable, decision variable. X and Y are non-negative. Identify set constraint. So what are the constraint? X type of cookie I cannot prepare. I can prepare greater than 80 but must be less than 120. Similarly, Y type of cookie I can prepare more than 120, less than 140. The minimum boundary and the maximum boundary. Already into that factory 80 numbers of cookies are prepared of this flavor. 120 numbers of cookies are prepared into this flavor. Now we need to increase up to 120, 140. That's all. So this is what our maximum capacity. We cannot prepare, depending upon the given constraint, we cannot prepare more than 120 cookies of this flavor, more than 140 cookies of this flavor. That's all. Now look at here. Finally, put together flavor X and flavor Y put together, I suppose not to exceed more than 240. That is another constraint. Demand may come also. But depending upon my setup, my manufacturing unit, I cannot improve more than 240 cookies. That's it. Now, we need to choose the method of solving the problem. So now we are choosing graphical methodology. How the graphical method is going to be helpful, let us look at. Now, this is the objective function. Already it is written. 0.88x plus 0.75y. What are all the constraints? There are three constraints we have taken, we have considered. So X flavor can be manufactured between the range 80 to 120. Similarly, Y flavor can be manufactured between the range 120 to 140. Put together should not exceed more than 240 because my unit capacity is not more than 240. That's it. Now with these four component, we may need to solve this problem. How we are going to solve? Let us see. Identify the feasible region. How you are going to identify the feasible region? So for that, you need to write down, look at here carefully. See my mouse, you can able to see here the larger band, pink colored larger band. This is of one constraint. What is this constraint? My bakery is capable of manufacturing 80 to 120x. So 80 pieces of cookies to 120 pieces. That is what it is highlighted here in this pink region. Similarly, the smaller pink region, the narrow pink region signifies 120 to 140. Look at here, 120 to 140, the manufacturing capacity. Next, put together, X and Y should not exceed more than 240. So I need to put an intersection point, 240 here, 240 here. I need to connect those two lines. That connector line only, blue color, because X and Y together, so that on the X direction 240 we need to cut here, Y direction 240 we need to cut here. So put together it should pass through. Now where your feasible solution available is, look at here, green color triangle. This is where your feasible solution is available. Then from which you need to find out the optimal solution. Green area is feasible solution. From the feasible solution, you need to find out the optimal solution. So what is the x value, what is the y value you want to find out best suitable to the unit is available within this green region. Any point you can pick up that is feasible. Upon these three constraints, that is feasible. But what is the best? We don't know. Then we need to choose. Look at here, there are three points are formed in this triangle region. This is linear optimization. Look at everywhere lines only used in order to find the feasible region. The moment you use straight lines, that comes into the category linear optimization. Anywhere the curvature other than line, any kind of shapes exist, then that becomes non-linear optimization. These three points you can pass through. So you can find out which direction you can find out the optimal solution. This point, this point, this point. All the, it is a triangle. Then clearly it is visible that there are three points only can be formed for triangle, formed used for triangle formation. So all those three points you are collecting, substitute. The profit is this, this, this after the substitution, which is giving the best profit or highest profit. 210 rupees is the highest profit you are getting. It is clearly, see, being a human being, we know 120 is your capacity, 140 is your capacity. That is the maximum capacity of your factory. So we ourselves can conclude how beautifully the mathematics guides us to reach that. Through common sense, we can identify 120, 140 is the maximum capacity of the manufacturing unit for each flavor respectively. And why can't we try that? That is a general tendency. But how the mathematics guides to arrive that solution? Yes, 120 is the maximum capacity of the X cookie. 140 is the maximum capacity of Y cookie. Only if I reach that number of manufacturing, I can attain the highest profit of $210.6. That's all. This is called optimized solution, maximized profit. That's it. So hope so you can able to understand what is it. Finally, inference. Maximum profit can be attained, generated in a day is $210.6. So this is what the inference you can take out of the entire optimization problem. Let us go back to the theory portion or the continuation of earlier discussion. Look at here, there is another problem. I am not going to solve this one. Just I am going to give you the scenario. Area of reinforcement with depth. What is the reinforcement? When the civil engineer starts constructing, if you look at my virtual background also, there is a beam. So a lot of beams are available in the virtual background. So when that bridge construction, reinforcement, cement reinforcement, concrete reinforcement, they used to say. So that reinforcement is represented with X1, width of the beam, X2, depth of the beam, X3. Minimize cost of the reinforcement. Civil engineer, how they will profit, they will make profit. Every engineer will think of how I can, they don't even bother about the quality, they will think of what first. How can I make profit out of this project? So how can I reduce the beam depth and width and reinforcement technique or the expenditure involved into the reinforcement? All these thought process only they will be considering. In those situations, we can apply optimization technique. So constraint, support minimum amount of load, bounds on width and depth ratio and variables. It is a positive variable, always it is positive. So these are all the boundary conditions available. So what is the depth and width of the beam? That is one condition. Amount of load. If it is the beam is central, the load would be different. The beam is side, it is different. So you can read that center of gravity and center of gravitational force. There are so many concepts. So that force, these all those things they will calculate, torque, these all they will calculate and they will take conclusion. So what is a load can be applied on the beam, side beam and center beam. So there are several techniques. So using those all, they need to find out the best method of beam reinforcement. So that is where again it is useful. This is one scenario for civil engineering. If you look at your textbook, minimum 10 scenarios they had given. This is one such scenario from the textbook only. So there are several scenarios have been discussed in your textbook. Next, coming to the point, optimization technique. How many optimization technique available? A fair idea only I am bringing. Continuous, discrete nature. Within discrete integer programming, whenever you see integer programming, that signifies directly discrete. Then one more is stochastic programming. So next is continuous. Within continuous, unconstrained, constrained, two different categories. The moment unconstrained comes, nonlinear least squares. So these are all two topic included for you. Global optimization, non-differentiable optimization, then constrained type, continuous and constrained. Linear programming, non-linearly constrained, bounded constraints, network programming, stochastic programming. So these are all the categories available into optimization. Next, non-linear smooth function is also available. Over that category, what is the meaning is, see, non-linear. Simply I have drawn, whatever comes to my thought, I have drawn this. If you look at this non-linear, what is the nature? It's not a straight line, that much you are sure. The function is different. It is not a linear function, it is non-linear function. By looking at the graph itself, you can conclude. What is smooth function? Never you can notice a discontinuity. It is continuous. That is called smooth function. Non-linear itself, two category. Smooth function, non-smooth function. The moment derivative, Hessians, derivatives, Gaussian and Hessian. First order derivative, Gaussian. Second order derivative, Hessian. What is derivative? Doing differential calculus, differentiation. For given the function, if you start doing differentiation, that is called derivatives. The moment the derivatives comes into the picture, those all termed as non-linear. That's it. In the machine learning, one such famous non-linear optimization problem is gradient descent. You would have noticed that problem. In order to find out the minimum loss or minimum RMSE, whatever. So you need to apply gradient descent optimization technique to find out the best fit. That is meant for best fit. The moment you say best fit, loss will be lesser. That's all. So in order to reduce the loss, you will be using gradient optimization. That is one best example for non-linear. Look at here, non-linear, but it is discontinuous in nature. There is a gap. See, I have aligned like this. So there are two different pieces. It can be here with a little gap, more gap, whatever. This is example for discontinuous or non-smooth function. That's it. If you want to know what is the meaning difference between smoothness, non-smoothness, continuity, discontinuity, here I am giving the link. You can explore a lot. There are several intellectual discussion had gone to this link, Quora. Next, what is non-linear optimization? A smooth non-linear program is otherwise called non-linear optimization. That's all. Now, is a smooth non-linear function of the decision variable. The moment decision variable, if you are using non-linear function. For example, X and Y are the two decision variables we have discussed in the previous problem statement. So if we look at, we are using a simple summation. This is called linear. We are identifying two different decision variables. X for representing one type of cookie, Y for representing yet another type of cookie. So we are using a simple summation through in which we are trying to find out what to say, the objective function. That is called linear. Now, the moment we are going for SQRT, square root. Square root will not allow one side of function at all. You cannot work on one. Constraint is different. Earlier case, we had given constraint, not a negative. Because you can't say 5 minus 50 cookies I have prepared means what is the meaning? preparation with minus 50 cookies, never it is impossible. That is constraint. But this is function. The function constraint is what here nonlinear. How it makes nonlinear is square root you cannot find out for negative values. 0 to negative values, this function is forbidden. Not at all possible to apply. This function will not work at all. Then it can be treated as nonlinear. It is not possible to differentiate. Derivatives you can't find out for negative values. That is where the subtle difference comes between linear and nonlinear. The moment when to use square root, that and all your context dependent. That I cannot say. You can apply even quadratic function or you can apply nonlinear 1 by x function. So the moment, for example, your equation, objective equation comes in this form. 1 by x plus sqrt of y. How I am forming? This is purely depending upon your case, your objective case study. So this is called objective function. This is best example for nonlinear function. The moment you started working on the nonlinear functions, it is called nonlinear optimization. The moment you work on the linear equation or linear combination, it is called linear optimization. I already said that writing down or coining the objective function is very challenging. So what relationship it possesses in your context? How it all variable can be put together? What is the interrelationship among the variable? What is a target, your final target? In the previous case, simple case which we have seen, x plus y equal to profit. That's all. Plus y, what else? How many pieces of x? What is the profit? 0.88 is the profit for one of the cookies. For yet another cookie, 0.75 is the profit. So finally, this is the equation related to profit. So this is the exact relationship can exist, not any other relationship. So in this situation, it is called linear. Similarly, given the scenario, what is the interrelationship between LHS and RHS? That decides the objective function, whether it is of linear type or nonlinear type. What way you can coin that objective function, that takes decision. That is a final answer, nothing more. But all the solution, the way of doing that, is 7 steps applicable for both linear optimization and nonlinear optimization. Where exactly it differs is only in the form of writing objective function. Nonlinear optimization, identify the decision variable, identify the objective function, identify the constraint. So all these 3 steps are common for both. Nothing is going to become different. Next, the moment you are into derivatives, then you are into nonlinear. Gradient, first order derivation is gradient, it is called. Similarly, second order derivative, it is called Hessian. So most of problem we used to solve with first order derivation. What is Hessian is second order derivation. Double after the first differentiation, you will do again one more differentiation. The function, the original function, which the moment you apply first time derivation, that is first order derivative. Whatever you are obtaining the other function, derivative function, for that once again if you apply differentiation, that is second order derivative. Hope so these two words, first order derivative, second order derivative, you would have seen in the gradient descent optimization technique, both in the machine learning and the deep learning. That's all. So this kind of problems you can solve using Newton-Raphson method also. This is one of the famous technique into numerical methods. So you would have come across that. That also you can use it for optimization. So linear optimization leads to lot of possible outcomes. One is unique optimal solution, alternative optimal solution. So you will have only one unique. Look at that, the problem which we have worked through. Only one unique solution. Only for one point you are getting the highest profitable region, profitable point. The moment you manufacture 120 or 240 units, only then you will reach the maximum 140, 120 and 140, you will reach the maximum profit. There is no more options. There are problem, you will end up with a multiple optimal solution. Unbounded solution, you cannot even find out, you cannot even think of so many solutions exist. Alternative means possibly 1, 2, 3, that's all. Unbounded means so many solutions. Then infeasible solution, when the demand requirement is higher than the available capacity, then that is infeasible solution. For example, my factory capacity for one cookie at the max is 140 units. But my demand is 800 units since it is Christmas and New Year season. 800 units or 1000 units people are asking for. Infeasible. I cannot even think of. So that is where this category comes into. Where and all it is applicable? Product mix, process selection, blending, portfolio selection, transportation, multi-period production planning, multi-period financial management, production marketing, these are all the arena it is applicable. What are all the decision variables? What is objective function? Not the equation written, whether it is maximized function or minimization function. What are all the constraints? Every problem, typically, we do have constraints. Without constraint, it is not at all. The moment there is no constraint means why we need to think and discuss and find out the solution. Everywhere constraint. So the moment constraint comes only, it becomes a problem. It requires experts' advice or decision making. Otherwise, it is not at all a issue. So this all the way we can think. Then simple bound, only one boundary. Look at here, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to. Then complex boundary. There are several boundary conditions. Similar, how so one solution, single solution, multiple solution, based on the outcome I discussed. Similarly, constraints also, several constraints available. Simple constraint, complex constraint, multiple constraints, something like that. This all case to case, problem to problem, it varies. So with that note, I'm concluding this topic on linear and nonlinear optimization.